nafshi, they call him al teichat kvodi. Very harsh words. So therefore, we would not suspect that the tribe of Levi would be the tribe that is singled out for public service in the Jewish people because of their violent past. But a number of things changed that, which is also a lesson. One change was that when the Jews were enslaved in Egypt, the Levim kept the tradition. The Levim were the ones that kept Shabbos. The Levim kept the traditions of the Jewish people. They did not allow themselves to assimilate, whereas the other tribes were much weaker and fell prey to the Medrash says that during the time of the Malkas Choshech, many of the Jewish people were destroyed simply because they didn't want to leave Egypt. So Levi redeems itself. It redeems itself by its loyalty to Jewish tradition. And then the Levim are the tribe from which Moshe and Aaron are descended. Amram and Moshe are descended from the Bnei Kohath, and they are the people who undertake the leadership role with all of the dangers and all of the negatives that come with that. Whatever we say about Moshe Rabbeinu, I doubt if anybody here would want to have the life that he had. And we see in Moshe himself a reflection of Levi, because just as Levi killed Shechem, Moshe kills the Mitzri, who is abusing a Jewish man and who has assaulted a Jewish woman. Moshe's sense of justice and rectitude was such that he could not bear it, just as Levi could not bear it. Levi says to Yaakov, "Achazona yaseh achaseh." So there are people that have that loyal impulse to the Jewish people. They can't bear to see the tzaras of the Jewish people. They can't bear to see the oppression. They have to at least speak out against it, if not take action about it. So that's the story of Moshe. And Aaron remained in Egypt during the entire period when the Jews were being enslaved, the last 80 years of the sojourn in Egypt. And Aaron suffers with them. And Aaron is their champion. And that's why Moshe himself says, "Kaviyochol to the Rabbonu Shel Olam, why should you choose me? Shlach Noviyat Tishlach, send Aaron." Aaron is entitled. But Aaron is Oev Sabrios. Rodev Shalom, Vakir Shalom, that's wonderful. But that's not necessarily the qualifications for a leader. A leader has to make hard decisions. Many times unpopular decisions. Everybody weeps when Aaron dies. Says Ayivko so called Bnei Yisrael, because Aaron was everybody's friend. Everybody loved Aaron. And Moshe died, so the Chumash doesn't say that everybody wept, that everybody was affected by it. Talmidei Chachamim were affected. Certain element of the people were affected, but there were other large elements of the people that said, you know, okay. Because Moshe is a tough guy. And Moshe is the one that says Chumash Dvorim today. And Moshe is the one that quelled the ego with a strong hand. And so that's the second thing that brings Shevet Levi to the fore, is that when it came to the Maaseh Ego, Moshe will say later, Esechov lo hikir, Esbonov lo yoda. Shevet Levi also cares for the Ribbono Shel Olam so deeply and for the Jewish people so deeply, can't bear to see the Ego. Can't bear to see it happen. And that is an element that has to be understood because it's not popular in our time. We don't like zealots. They are not popular. They don't speak to us. We want everybody to be nice. Because I'll say we're going to have here in Chumash Bamidbar, we're going to have the story of Pinchas. So the Torah is miyachis it. The Torah says Pinchas ben Elazar ben Aaron HaKohen. Why does the Torah? Pinchas killed Cosby, and killed Shlumiel, the Nasi of the tribe of Shimon. So Rashi quotes already the Gemara that the Jews said, you know, Pinchas killed him because he's descended from Yisrael. One of the wives, his grandmother, was from Yisrael. And therefore, that's the non-Jewish gene within him that allows him to kill a prince in Israel, the head of the tribe, to take the law into his own hands, so to speak. So the Torah came to disabuse us of that idea. And it said, Pinchas ben Elazar ben Aaron HaKohen. He's descended from Aaron. So even though Aaron is Oev Shalom, Rodev Shalom, Oev Esabrios, Mekorim LaTorah, but there's Aloha of Kanoim Pogimbo. And when such a disaster happens in front of the Jewish people, and the leader of the Jewish people participates in it, so then that's part of the job of the Kohen and the Levi to speak out against it and here to take action against it. And so that's a very thin line when one is entitled to do it or not. I think in the whole history of the Jewish people, we find very few people who rated the title of being a true Kanoi. Maybe the other one is Elio Anovi, who said, Kano Kinesi Lashem. But we saw the Ribbono Shel Olam dampened him as well. So there was divided into the Jewish people this tribe of Levi. Within the tribe itself, there is a division between Kohanim and Levim. So the Kohanim were the ones that did the Bnei Aaron, who did the service in the Beis HaMikdash, in the Mishkan, and also were the teachers of Israel. The Navi will say later, Kisif Seichoi Yishmu Das, Vittori Yavakshu Mepiyu. That was their job. So their job was to be the moral guardians of the Jewish people. Because it says, Ki Malach Hashem Tzvokosu. He's an angel of God. So the Gemara says that he, Im Malach Hashem Tzvokosu, then Torah Yavakshu Mepiyu. if he is a moral example for the people, then the people will want to study Torah from him. But if he's lacking in that, then certainly it won't happen. So the Kohen had the definite task of the Avodah and the Beis HaMikdash, and the Kohanim had no means of support, and they were dependent on the people, Truma, other than the 24 gifts of the Kohanim. The Levim were the substitute for the Bechorim of Klal Yisrael, who originally were entitled to be the leaders of the people, but because of their failure at the Egel, so we read in last week's parsha that the Ribbono Shel Olam redeemed them. The Levim redeemed them, and the Levim took their spot, they took their position to be again, servants in the Beis HaMikdash and teachers of Israel. And this was their task. This is who they were supposed to be. Now in later times, we find, for instance, during the times of the Hashmonaim, so Hashmonaim were Kohanim. But they took for themselves the right to be the king, which was reserved for the tribe of Yehuda. Lo yosur shevet mi Yehudon lechokek mi ben raglot. So Kohen Gadol was one thing, the king was another. At the time of the Hashmonaim, they attempted to make it one and the same person, to concentrate all the power, all the leadership in one person. And Chazal disagreed with it. And Marath Medushin teaches us that they said to the king, to Yanai, it's enough that you're the Kohen, Hanach Lecha, Keser Murcha, leave over the kingdom for others, royalty for others. He did not take kindly to that. In the Civil War, they said, the Prushim Alecha, the Rabbonim, the rabbis, you know, the Haredim are against you. And there was a civil war. Thousands of people were killed in the war. Josephus describes it for us. And many of the Talmidei Chachomim fled and went into exile into Egypt, Shimon ben Shetach and others, because of the fact that they wanted to erase that line. So there are lines in the Jewish world. Kohen is one line, Levi is another line, Melucha is another line. And the fact that these are reserved for different groups of the Jewish people is part of the divine plan, that's how it's supposed to work. So again, in our time, when we think always in terms of democracy today and everybody equal and everything, so then people find it hard to understand and accept. I mean, why can't I be a Kohen? Why can't I be a Levi? Why can't the Kohen be the Melech? He's the best one. But the Torah, which had insight into true nature of people, set up these divisions that we see in the Parsha. And within the Levim themselves, they're divided. There's Gershon, Kohos, Merari. Different tasks, different talents, different goals, different values. So all of these things come to point out to us the nature of the Jewish people and how we should be able to view these things. Rabbi Hananiah ben Akashio, Meotzachon, Borgo, Lodakim, Tzitz Yisrael, Vichach, Hirbo, Lahem, Torah, Mitzvot, Sinema, Lamech, Avetim,